In this video, we will be discussing about Jean Watson's theory of human caring. Coming to the background of the theorist, Margaret Jean Harmon, born in a small town in the West Virginia in 1940s. She got graduated from the Lewis Gale School of Nursing in 1961, and then she continued her nursing studies at the University of Colorado. In 61, she got married to Douglas Watson, and she began her nursing career in 1964 after receiving her B.S. in nursing from University of Colorado, Boulder. In 1966, she received her M.S. In psychiatric and mental health nursing from the University of Colorado, Denver. And in 73, she got a doctorate in educational psychology and counseling from the University of Colorado, Boulder. And Jean Watson is known for a widely published author and recipient of several awards and honors. And she got 15 honorary doctoral degrees, including 12 international honorary doctorates. And her research has been in the area of human caring and loss. The foundation of Jean Watson's theory of nursing was published in 1979 in Nursing, the Philosophy and Science of Caring. And in 1988, her theory was published in Nursing, Human Science and Human Care. In 2002, she published the book Assessing and Measuring Caring in Nursing and Health Science. Coming to the career milestones of Jean Watson, she is a famous author and co-author for over 20 books. She is the past president of National League of Nursing, fellow of American Academy of Nursing. She is a distinguished professor of nursing and chair in caring science at the University of Colorado Health Sciences Center. And she is the founding member of International Association in Human Caring and International Caritas Consortium. She is the founder and director of the Watson Caring and Science Institute. In 2010, she launched the Millionaires Global Caring Field Project, and in October 2013, she was inducted as a living legend by the American Academy of Nursing. The purpose of developing this theory, Jean Watson developed this theory based on the Watson's desire to re-establish holistic practice in nursing care and move away from the cold and disconnected scientific model while infusing feeling and caring back into the nursing practice. The purpose was to provide a philosophical, ethical foundation from which the nurse could provide care. She also proposed the benefit of this theory for both the nurse and the patient is that when each person reveals his or her authentic self and engages in interaction with another being, the energetic field around both of them will change and enhance the healing environment. The caring assumptions in the Jean Watson's theory. Caring can be effectively demonstrated and practiced interpersonally. Caring consists of curative factors that can fulfill human needs. Effective caring promotes health and individual and family growth. Caring responses accept a person as he is and looks beyond to what that person may become. A caring environment offers the development of potential while allowing a person to choose the best action at a given time. Caring is equally important as curing. The practice of caring integrates biophysical knowledge with the knowledge of human behavior to generate or promote health and to assist those who are ill. The science of caring and science of curing are interrelated and are not mutually exclusive. The practice of caring is central to nursing. Caring denotes a nurse's responsiveness to a client's problem. The nurse and the client collaborate to help the client gain control, knowledge, and help. She developed the conceptual elements of 10 curative factors: transpersonal caring relationship, then caring moment or caring occasion. So these are the conceptual elements in the Jean Watson's theory. So what are the karyotype factors? There are 10 karyotype factors which provide structure or, to the caring assumptions, and each factor has a dynamic phenomenological component, that is developing a human consciousness and self-awareness relative to persons involved in the nursing relationship. The first caring factor is, first karyotype factor is humanistic altruistic value system. It begins developmentally at an early age with values shared with the parents, but can be greatly influenced by the nursing educators. This value system can be accomplished by examining one's views, beliefs, and interactions with various cultures as well as personal growth experience. It provides satisfaction through giving and extending oneself. Second one is instilling faith, hope. It is essential to both the curative and the curative process. When modern science has nothing further to offer the person, the nurse can continue to use faith, hope to provide a sense of well-being through belief which are meaningful to the individual. Address the nurse's role in promoting wellness in this curative factor. Third one is cultivating sensitivity to oneself and to others. Development of one's own feeling is needed to interact genuinely and sensitivity with the others. Striving to become sensitive makes the nurse more authentic, which encourages self-growth and self-actualization in both nurse and those with whom the nurse is interacting. The nurse promotes health and higher level of functioning only when they form person-to-person relationship. Fourth one is developing a helping trust relationship. Here, the nurse establishes a rapport and caring, helps to promote expression of positive and negative feelings. It is accomplished through congruence, empathy, non-possessive warmth, and effective communication. So the communication can include verbal, non-verbal, and listening. Fifth one is promoting expression of positive and negative feelings. According to Watson, feelings alter thoughts and behavior, and they need to be considered and allowed for in a caring relationship. According to her, such expression improves one's level of awareness. Awareness of feelings helps to understand the behavior and its endangers. Sixth one is systematic use of the scientific problem-solving method for decision-making. According to Watson, the scientific problem-solving method is the only method that allows for control and prediction and that permits self-correction. She also values the relative nature of nursing and supports the need to examine and develop the other method of knowing to provide a holistic perspective. The science of caring should not be always neutral and objective. Seventh one is promoting interpersonal teaching learning. The caring nurse must focus on the learning process as much as the teaching process. Understanding the person's perception of the situation assists the nurse to prepare a cognitive plan. Eighth one is providing a supportive, protective or corrective mental, physical, socio-cultural and spiritual environment. Watson divides these into external and internal variables which the nurse manipulates in order to provide support and protection for the person's mental and physical well-being. The external and internal environment are interdependent. She suggests that the nurse also must provide comfort, privacy and safety as a part of these curative factors. Ninth one is assisting with the gratification of human needs. So this ninth curative factor is grounded with the hierarchy of need, which is similar to the Maslow's hierarchy. And she has created a hierarchy which she believes it is relevant to the science of caring in nursing. So according to her, each need is equally important for quality nursing care and the promotion of optimal health. So all the needs deserve to be attended to and it should be valued. So according to here it requires a person requires meeting a lower order needs before attaining a higher order needs. So Watson identifies a hierarchy of needs which include lower order needs like biophysical needs, and higher order needs are psychosocial needs, intrapersonal and interpersonal needs. So according to her, she has developed a needs which is based on the Maslow's hierarchy, and she divided that into lower order needs that are the biophysical needs like need for food and fluid, need for elimination, need for ventilation, and the psychophysical needs, they are also lower order needs. They are the need for activity and inactivity, need for sexuality. So these all will come under the lower order needs. And then the higher order needs, they are the psychosocial needs. They are the need for achievement, the need for affiliation. And the higher order need, another is divided as intrapersonal and interpersonal need. And the last is the need for self-actualization. So according to her, the lower order need is biophysical need and psychophysical needs. So these two are the lower order needs. Okay. So in the biophysical needs, there are need for food, elimination, ventilation, and coming to the psychosocial need, activity, inactivity, sexuality, this all will come under lower order need. And the higher order need is the psychosocial need, which is the need for achievement and affiliation. And the last one is self-actualization. Coming to the 10th karate factor, that is the allowance for existential phenomenological forces. Phenomenology is a way of understanding people from the way the things appear to them. Their experiences shape their individual perceptions. So this leads to a better understanding of oneself and of others. Next is the evolution of Gene Watson's curative factors into the Caritas process. So we will see the differences between the curative factors and the Caritas process. So in before that, we will see what is the Caritas process. In 2001, Watson introduced the concept of clinical Caritas process, which has since replaced the curative factors. The word Caritas originates from the Greek vocabulary meaning to cherish and to give special loving attention. The clinical Caritas process emphasizes a greater spiritual dimension, and the difference between the curative factors and the Caritas process are like this. The first is the formation of humanistic altruistic system of values. The first curative factor in Caritas process, it is practicing loving kindness and equanimity. Next is installation of faith and hope. So the second curative factor, that is being authentically present and enabling and sustaining the deep belief system of self and one being cared for. Next is cultivation of sensitivity to oneself and others. Here it is cultivating one's own spiritual practices. It is deepening one's self-awareness and going beyond the ego self. Next one is a development of helping, trusting or human caring relationship. So that is the developing and sustaining a helping or trusting authentic caring relationship in Caritas process. The next is a promotion and acceptance of the expression of positive and negative feelings. That is considered as the being present to and supportive of the expression of positive and negative feelings. And the next is curative factory, systematic use of the scientific problem solving method of decision making. So creatively problem solving is the Caritas process, solution seeking through caring process. Next is proportion of interpersonal teaching leading. So here it is engaging in transpersonal learning within the context of caring relationship, staying within others' frame of reference. Next is the provision for a supportive, protective and or creative mental, physical, social, cultural and spiritual environment. In this in Caritas process, it is creating a healing environment at all levels. Next is assistance with the gratification of human needs. So assisting with basic needs as sacred acts like touching mind, body, spirit of others, or sustaining human dignity. The allowance of existential phenomenological forces, that is the opening to spiritual mystery and unknowns, that is allowing for miracles. So these are the difference between the 10th charity factor and 10th charitas process. Coming to the second concept, there is a transpersonal caring relationship. For Watson in 1999, the transpersonal caring relationship characterizes a special kind of human care relationship that depends on the nurse's moral commitment in protecting and enhancing human dignity, as well as the deeper or higher the nurse's caring consciousness that is communicated to preserve and honor the embodied spirit, therefore not reducing the person to the moral status of an object. Again, she says that this relationship describes how the nurse goes beyond an objective assessment, showing concerns toward the person's subjective and deeper meanings regarding their own healthcare situation. The goal of a transpersonal caring relationship corresponds to protecting, enhancing, and preserving a person's dignity, humanity, wholeness, and inner harmony. Next, the third concept is the caring occasion or caring moment. So this is occurring during the various nursing interventions and interaction with each patient. This portion of theory focuses on an actual tangible moment in the time in which the nurse recognizes the connection that is developed between him or herself and the patient. This moment dictates the ability for the nurse to have an overall impact on the patient. Then the caring and healing model of the theory. The nurse is able to help the patient with the overall well-being by assisting them with the release of disharmony or blocked energy. The use of this portion of the theory helps the patient with overall healing and renewal. Nurses can impact the patient through health promotion, health restoration, and illness prevention. So coming to the metaparadigm of the theory, for metaparadigm we will see in detail. The first one is person. In Jean Watson's theory, she views person as a human being to be valued, cared for, respected, nurtured, understood, and assisted. Person is greater than and different from the sum of the parts. Person must be viewed according to the client's development and the conflicts arising in this development. The individuality of each person is important, and she defines, coming to the environment, she defines the environment as a society with all of its influences. A caring attitude is not transmitted from one generation to another generation. It is transmitted by the culture of the profession as a unique way of coping with its environment. It encompasses social, cultural, and spiritual aspects. Next is health. Watson believes that there are other factors that are needed to be included in the WHO definition of health. So she adds the following three elements into the WHO definition, and she defines health as like in this her theory. That is a high level of overall physical, mental, and social functioning, a general adaptive maintenance level of daily functioning, and the absence of illness or the presence of efforts that leads its absence. So these three elements has to be included in the WHO definition of health according to Watson. Next is nursing. Nursing is concerned with promoting health, preventing illness, and acting for the sick and restoring health. Nursing focuses on health promotion and treatment of disease. She believes that holistic health care is central to the practice of caring in nursing. She defined nursing as a human science of persons and human health illness experiences that are mediated by professional, personal, scientific, aesthetic, and ethical human transactions.